Welcome to today's episode of Grow It Green. We're here with Margaret Hagen of the UNH Cooperative Extension. Hi, Margaret.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Winter's over. Spring is here. People are going to start heading out to grow their own vegetables, but there are some things we need to think about, right?
Right. People want to grow their own food these days. They want to know where their food is coming from. But lead is an issue in soils in New Hampshire, and lead comes from basically three different places. Lead will come from lead paint on a house that was painted prior to the 1950s, and every time it was scraped, chips fell to the ground that have lead in them. Lead will come from leaded gasoline up until the 1970s, and lead may be present from pesticides used in orchard land. So if you have a new home on an orchard land, you might want to test the soil. You might want to test the soil anyway so you have the best vegetable garden possible. But you also want to do it because the soil test will tell you whether you have a very low, medium, or high lead in your soil. And at a low level, it's not an issue. At a very low level, it's not an issue. At a low level, you probably want to try and make sure you have more than 5% organic matter and that your pH is high. Around 6 to 7, and pH in New Hampshire, we tend to have more acid soil, so you have to apply lime and organic matter. And you can eat root crops and leafy vegetables at a very low level as long as you wash them really carefully and get every speck of dust off. At a medium level, you might want to only grow things that fruit, like tomatoes and melons and cucumbers and beans, things that aren't in really close contact with soil. And if you have a very high level, you either need to put in raised beds like these with soil that you've brought in from someplace else, or you should not grow edible crops there at all. So it's worth knowing, if you're putting in a new vegetable garden, what the lead level is in your soil.
Because when you ingest that through the vegetables, it's unhealthy.
It's unhealthy for you, but it's more importantly, it's unhealthy for children who still have developing bodies. So it's very simple to take a soil test. You just gather soil from three or four places in the garden and mix it all together in a bucket, and then you're going to want to pull about half a cup. And you can download this form online and fill it out. You can check off 9 different crops on it, fruits and vegetables, whatever it is that you're growing, berries. And it will come back and tell you what you need to add for lime and fertilizer and what your lead levels and organic matter levels are. And then if you're interested in just lead itself, you can go online or call the info line and get this fact sheet on lead in soils.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Thanks, Margaret.
You're welcome.
Keeping us safe. We'll see you next time.